I love this place. There's always something going on. Oh, I should introduce myself. I'm one of the Abbey corbels, a head carved in stone, and I've been here for hundreds of years. You know, the Abbey can be a place of calm, but it can also be noisy with worship and singing and so on. But the noisiest it has ever been was when Henry III decided to rebuild the place. Once the builders and artists and artisans had gone and the dust had settled, I remember there being such a sense of calm. And when I think back to that calm, I think of this treasure. It's a retable, a beautiful work of art and the centrepiece of the Abbey's new altar. It looks a little worn and torn now, but don't forget, it's over 750 years old. Almost as old as me. I remember the congregation coming in when Henry's rebuilt abbey was reopened. The people sitting there gazing around in wonder. And what caught most people's attention? The retable and the stories it told. Well, looking at it now, I bet your eye is drawn to the blank spaces. But there is one story that you could just about make out. There, in one of those stars on the left. It's the story of Jairus and his daughter. Maybe you know it. Jairus was an elder at the synagogue, and at the time of our story, his young daughter was very ill in bed. A mother had heard the great teacher Jesus was nearby, so she urged her husband to go and bring him to their house. Perhaps he might be able to save their little girl. Now, we don't know a great deal about how Jairus went about finding Jesus. He would have had to fight his way through the jostling crowds and push his way to the front. Once he did find him, the two men then made their way back to Jairus' house. However, as they neared his home, Jairus must have feared the worst as they were met by the sounds of wailing and weeping. It could only mean one thing. They were too late. Jairus' daughter had died. But Jesus continued to make his way through the crowd until he came to the house, now full of mourners, crying for the girl. "She isn't dead," said Jesus. "She's only sleeping." Well, at these words, the crying of the crowd turned to mocking laughter, but Jesus pushed his way to the girl's bedside, took her hand in his, and spoke clearly. "Little girl, get up." And at these words, the girl's eyes began to flutter. She gasped and sat up in bed. She was alive. "She is hungry. Give her something to eat," said Jesus. And just before leaving the family to their joy, his parting words were, "Don't tell anyone about this." I wonder why. Can you imagine Jairus' family trying to keep this story a secret? Someone must have talked us. Here it is. One of the stories on our retable. A picture for worshippers to wonder about the young girl's resurrection. Perhaps in some small way, Henry III wanted that story to feature as it mirrors his raising a new Westminster Abbey from the old. But what do I know? I'm just an old stone corbel.